And so even as politics over Balakot plays out, Wion World is One is busting the lie Islamabad has been peddling. Wion's correspondent traveled to Balakot, where Indian Air Force carried out the strike and destroyed Jaish-e-Mohammad's biggest training camp. This is what has been revealed in this report.
Wion World is One traveled to the Jaba top, which is roughly 24 kilometers from Balakot city. There are two ways to get to the Jaba hilltop. One is the civilian route and the other is an uphill trek. At the foothill, Wion World is One saw a board of a seminary called Madrasa Talim ul Quran. The board at the foothill mentioned that the seminary is under the leadership of Muhammad Masood Azhar and under the watch of Maulana Muhammad Yusuf Azhar. The board declares it is a bus stop and gives directions to the seminary. That was route one. Route 2, which is the direct trek, was closed for both media and locals. There were bearded men sitting inside jeeps who stared at us when Wion filmed the board as well. Wion's team had to opt for Route 1, which is a civilian route next to a tea stall. Our team saw that there was heavy military presence in the area. The Frontier Constabulary was guarding the area and the Pakistan Army was ahead of the Wion team and was scanning for IEDs. After a 4.5-kilometer walk, Wion World is One reached the point where the first Indian Air Force bomb was dropped. There was a crater, roughly 4 feet deep and 3 feet wide. Another 200 meters ahead was the site of the second bomb. Wion saw the sites where the third and the fourth bombs were dropped. All had similar craters.
These are craters. I'm standing in one of the craters as well. And this is the third and fourth crater. Now, if my camera can show you as well, these are those shells or those body parts of that particular payload or the bomb, as the Pakistani Minister of Defense, Mr. Parvez Khattak, had said. Remember, four of these were dropped. This is crater number three, and right to my left, if my cameraman can show you as well, that's crater number four.
Wion World is One spoke to the residents of the area off camera. Jaba top locals confirmed that there was a camp in the vicinity, and that is the Jihad training camp for Jaish's Bahawalpur seminary. Locals confirmed that Masood Azhar visits the camp on any Thursday at least once a month for his motivational address. There are about 600 to 700 students of different age groups in this particular seminary. We tried to film a few houses on the route to the seminary, but locals asked us to delete the footage. Residents told Wion that they heard the jets and the blasts, but did not realize what was happening. Ground reports confirmed that there were several injuries, but that was in the no-go area. From our visit to the area where the strike was conducted, Wion can confirm from its ground visit that there is an active presence of the Jaish-e-Mohaamad in the area. Wion can confirm that there were casualties greater and higher than what Pakistan has claimed. Now, we at Wion World is One are reiterating that we were not allowed to go all the way up to the seminary. We are also not clear about the identity of the men in the jeep that monitored our movements while we were filming in the area.
This is crater number three.
Now, the two big questions that arise out of Wion's report from Balakot are, why were there security personnel who stopped us from using the second route to the hilltop? And why was there an attempt to control what we filmed and reported?
A lot of security presence as we speak.